Joana Saíra with an improvised video shot from my backyard just before it starts to rain, because it will start very fast, so let's get this baby done, about some of the biggest lessons I learned from working with Om Kulsum music, listening to Om Kulsum music and dancing to Om Kulsum music. I'm going to share some of the biggest jewels I have collected from Om Kulsum as a dancer and also as a person. Now, before I share those goodies with you, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about myself. Of course, it is the protocol. In case you don't know me yet, I'm a world-renowned Oriental dancer, teacher, choreographer, author, and I'm also the creator of the pioneering Joana Saíra's World and Joana Saíra's Online Dance School, delivering authentic Egyptian dance, personal discovery, and empowerment. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, it's time I ask you to do so, because it helps the channel and it shows that you like the content I'm producing. So I'm gonna produce more and I'm gonna produce better for you. So subscribe now and click on the notifications bell button so that you know every time I have new goodies coming into the channel. Last but not least, like this video if you like it, share it with your dance peeps, and feel welcome to join Joana Saíra's World newsletter if you want to be the first to receive our inspirations, gifts, and exclusive content I only share with my beautiful people. Find the link to subscribe in the description box below this video. And now I'm going to tell you about three big treasures, big lessons, big jewels or gifts I have received from working, creating with the music of Om Kulsum, from listening to the music of Om Kulsum. So jewel number one, or gift number one, is I have become a better listener overall. Why? Because when we listen to Om Kulsum music and we listen for real, we notice how many details, how many transitions, how many subtle little nuances, how many instruments, how many different rhythms and melodies and styles and moods and moments she can fit in one single song. It's like a carnival. It's like going into a multicolored, hyper-stimulating ride for your ears. So the more you listen to Om Kulsum's music and the more you dance to it, the more you sharpen your ears and the more attentive your ears become, that will obviously change the way you react to music overall and also the way you react to life. Because in life, very often we don't listen. We don't listen to ourselves. We don't listen to the people that surround us. We don't listen to nature. We don't listen to the birds singing in the back. We don't listen to the wind, to the air. And this may sound romantic or philosophical for a lot of you, but if it does, it means you have lost a big part of the magic of being alive. Don't do that. And if you are there, go back. You can still be alive again, okay? And engaged with dance, engaged with life. So gift number one is to have become a better listener in my dance and in my life. Gift number two, it's about the courage to expose myself. Woo, this is a big one for a dancer, especially for a performer, but it is even bigger, more important for a person. What do I mean by showing myself or revealing myself or exposing myself? It means that Om Kulsum is an example of someone who put her soul into each word, who put her soul into each moment, even when she was present without singing, and you can see her doing that in live concerts that you can find on YouTube. She was totally there. She was so engaged and so in love with the music, and she was tuning into her own vulnerability. When she sang about her life. She sang about her heart. She sang about her sensitivity, her dreams, her frustrations, her fears. She revealed who she was in full, open, brave vulnerability. And that, my dear, is your biggest tool, your biggest gift as a dancer, but also as a human being. Because if you have your heart closed, you cannot get into the magic, into the beauty of Egyptian dance, and you definitely cannot get into the beauty and the magic of life. Third gift, and the last for this video, is one that I rarely see in dancers, and that is the ability to communicate doing nothing. Yes. We're so obsessed with movement, with physical movement, with noise. But Om Kulsum showed me that sometimes the most powerful parts of music and the most powerful parts of a dance piece and the most powerful parts of our lives are experienced in pure stillness. The magic, the beauty, the thing is often in the pause, in the silence, in the moment between movements, in the moment between sounds, when we are still, when we are present and fully engaged with who we are. No movement, no struggle, no showing off, no nothing, just being. That too, Om Kulsum has taught me. Now, there are so many more gifts that I would love to share with you. If you want to know more about this and other gifts I have learned from Om Kulsum, I will welcome you to join our newsletter, Joana Seira's World Newsletter. You will find the link below this video. And there, you will receive updates on a lot of material that I'm about to release on Om Kulsum, on Egyptian dance, personal discovery, and empowerment. You'll get all the news about the voice of Egypt and about your own voice through Egyptian dance. Follow the link, subscribe to our newsletter now, and I will see you very soon. Until then, receive my love and my usual kiss. Mwah!